let your backbone slip. Shake it to the east, shake it to the west, shake it to the one that you love the best. Your mama says so, your papa says so. That's the way to shake it when you want to catch a boat.
Kaboom!
Rachel, you sure know how to dance.
Well, don't you worry about it.
My turn.
Little Sally Walker, sitting in a saucer. Rise, Sally, rise. Wipe your weeping eyes. Put your hands on your hips and make your backbone slip. Shake it to the left. Shake it to the left. Shake it to the one that you love.
When you wake up early in the morning, feeling sad like so many of us do. I'm a little soul, may life your goal. And surely something's gotta come to you
and say it's all right.
Grandma,
dance! Baby,
it's defeats
day off. Come on, dance, Robert. Come on.
That ain't dancing, what y'all be doing anyway.
Well, don't you let this meat burn.
Hey, don't worry about the meat. Just check out these dancing feet.
Give yourself a chance.
You look like a worm in hot ashes. You ought to be ashamed of all that dance.
Those who can't dance can't claim I can't prance.
Shoot!
Come on, Paulette. You know you're still Grandma's baby.
Paulette, now you know Grandmama's raising Kevin, and he's just like family.
I'm glad we're not cousins. Mm. If we were, we couldn't get married.
Boy, shut up!
Give me that buck. Let's have some fun here.
It just doesn't seem like I'm gonna make the cheerleading squad.
Oh, girl, you are gonna make it. Just like I made it at my school. You gotta think positively.
I'm positive. Positive I'm not gonna make it. They always pick the girls that look like Barbie.
That's because your school's all white, and you're built like the Hulk.
Paulette!
Thanks a lot.
Clear?
By climbing over that fence. Y'all don't believe fat meat's greasy, do you?
We're sorry, Annie.
And I told you about calling me Annie, too.
Jenny calls you Annie.
You ain't Jenny. I raised Jenny, didn't raise you. Did you'd have a whole lot more manners.
We're sorry, Miss Annie.
Sorry don't prop up that fence, so y'all stay off it.
Yes, ma'am, Miss Annie.
Ought to have the sheriff put electricity through it. Little managed thing.
Stop making faces at my grandma, Lloyd.
I'm Lloyd. He's Floyd. Y'all missed a real good baseball game today.
Well, maybe we can play tomorrow if we don't have to look after my mama.
I hit a home run. So did your boyfriend.
No, he didn't, because I don't have a boyfriend.
Well, that's not what Kevin says.
Well, he's just a story. I wouldn't have Kevin. He thinks he's cute with his rail-headed self.
Rachel, come here.
Yes, ma'am.
Take this to Miss Connolly. She's resting in the living room.
Yes, ma'am. Do I have to come here tomorrow?
Well, maybe not, if I can get the bulk of this housework out of the way. But I can't do that and tend to her, too. So you sit in there with her in case she needs anything.
Okay.
Or help going to the bathroom.
Yes, ma'am. Here you go, Miss Lily.
Oh, thank you, Rachel. Rachel, why don't you get that table right over there?
Oh.
Yes. Okay. If you set it up right here, make it a little bit easier. Thank you, honey. Sit down. Born for you, Rachel.
No, ma'am. I like talking to you about things. Especially about books and stuff.
Oh. This is so delicious. Every time I think of that hospital food, I could shudder. I believe it did me more harm than the gallstone did. Is Annie teaching you how to cook?
Yes, ma'am. Mama does, too.
Good, good. Oh, but I bet you miss playing with your friends and doing whatever it is children do.
No, ma'am. I play with them enough.
I'm glad to get to know you better. You're a very nice little girl.
Thank you, Miss Lily.
And well-mannered.
Thank you, Miss Lily.
Rachel. Would you like to do work for me when you grow up?
No, thank you, Miss Lily. I want to be a school teacher.
I won't be needing you anymore today, Rachel. You can go now, Rachel.
Yes, ma'am.
Be finished today, Mr. Landon.
I know that, William, but there's just no way I can pay you today.
But you know, I got a family, Mr. Landon. I got mouths to feed, and so does Otis here.
We all got mouths to feed, boy. You're not the only one with problems. You think your problems are any more important than mine? I give you my word, you'll get the money.
You know where to reach me, Mr. Lamb.
Chances grow better, for there's no hiding place against the kingdom's throne. So people get ready, there's a train a-coming. You don't need no baggage, you just get on board. All you need is faith to hear the Jesus calling. So people get ready, there's a train a-coming. You don't need no baggage, you just get on. All you need is faith.
Hey, how y'all doing, huh?
And now President Lyndon Baines Johnson.
Hey, Paulette, turn that back.
No,
stop that.
Don't mean to do. We're trying to listen to the radio.
Or from the window where I sit with the problems of our country. I recognize
it's about that time.
About what time?
Time for us to stop asking white folks for the right time, when we should have already had a piece of the clock.
I know that's right.
It's gonna take a lot more than some new law to make that happen.
What's it gonna take, Daddy?
It's gonna take somebody's blood, baby. I'm thinking most of that blood's gonna be colored.
Effort of American Negroes to secure for themselves the full blessings of American life. Their cause must be our cause too, because it's not just Negroes, but really it's all of us who must overcome the crippling legacy of bigotry and injustice, and we shall overcome.
Daddy, what's wrong?
It's that old fool Lyndon Johnson. What's wrong? He's trying to pass some dumb voting laws, and I'm the one who's got to enforce them. I don't relish being put in that position by nobody.
But you always said the law was the law.
Jenny, there is the law. Then there's a law that's got to be lived with here in Catesville. Do you understand
the man
that?
Whose roots go deeply.
Your mom upstairs?
Down goes the drawbridge. Out goes the bad guy.
I say here, drawbridge down, drawbridge up.
That he used to whip all the time.
Why'd he whip the cat?
I don't know, he just did. Will you just let me tell a joke? So one day, he whipped the cat and put it in the freezer.
The freezer?
Yes, the freezer. Will you let him tell a joke?
So the man's wife found the cat in the freezer and called the veterinarian. The vet took one look at that cat and only one thing might could save it. So he took the cat outside and put 3 drops of gasoline under his tongue. The cat jumped up real fast. Ran around the house 3 times, then fell over on its side.
Wait a minute, was the cat dead?
No, he just ran out of gas.
Oh, that's
so funny. Was that the whole joke?
Well, times are rough. Even the jokes are poor.
Shoot, I don't know what you're talking about. That cat joke's a doozy. My club-footed Uncle Johnny from Jackson told me that joke. And he's funnier than Bill Cosby and Dick Gregory put together.
Yeah, well, there ain't too much funny going on in Jackson these days.
I know that's right. I saw him on the late news. They were sticking people with cattle prods and then running over them with horses and everything.
Well, that serves them right. They ought to know their place.
No, that's not right. You wouldn't want anybody sticking you with a cattle prod and running over you.
Rachel, they're breaking the law. My daddy says he doesn't want trouble here in Catesville, and he wouldn't stand for civil rights workers and outside agitators causing trouble.
The civil rights people are nonviolent.
Yeah, but Miss Annie says the civil rights workers are crazy for not fighting back. They're going to get arrested anyways.
Well, my daddy says they ought to put him in a cage, throw away the key, and keep him there locked up.
Floyd, you're about an ignorant little chump when you want to be.
How you calling ignorant?
I'm calling you ignorant.
You guys, wait a minute. You guys, I still don't think that we need people telling us how to live. I think we get along just fine. Don't you all think so?
Sure.
Yeah. Little
so I do. Improvement. Hey, what you say we go play a game of baseball tomorrow?
I said, cut that out now. I'm not playing with you all. Now, y'all know better than that. This ain't no park. Y'all get hurt running around here.
Somebody that I'd like to kiss.
Who?
I'm not saying.
Floyd and Lloyd!
Rachel, please be quiet.
You like Floyd and Lloyd!
Not both of them, stupid.
The door's locked!
Well, which one, Jamie? Come on.
The door's locked and I gotta go bed!
Let me see what you're talking about.
Nobody'll know. Go on, Polly, and hurry up.
Jenny.
Don't worry about it. Jeez.
What y'all up to?
Nothing. We were waiting for the bathroom. There's someone in the men's bathroom, too, so if you want to come back in a few minutes.
That's all right. I'm gonna have to go.
Lloyd, we were having a private talk. No, so...
Could you please leave?
Paula, that's the white bathroom. What are you doing in there?
Hey, y'all, come here. Quick. Hurry up. Hurry up.
Wait, Lloyd. Don't tell anyone, okay?
But that's the white bathroom.
Just don't tell anyone.
Look at that color man sitting in front of us.
All right, we don't want to lose anybody, especially you, Victor.
Huh? Those must be the civil rights workers with Martin Luther King, like the ones we saw on TV.
Hi.
What do you want?
I just want to get some gas. I'll pump it myself if you want me to.
Oh, you ain't pumping nothing. You all better get out of this town.
Well, if I don't get any gas, I can't go.
Well, I think I can get you going.
Hi.
I'm Glenn.
My name is Rachel.
Hi, Rachel. They sure have some pretty women around here. Listen, I'm looking for a Reverend Wilson, the Baptist Church. You know where I could find him?
Well, what do y'all kids think this is? Circus come to town now. Y'all come on. I want y'all to go home now. Or I call your mama. Come on.
Dad.
Jenny, that means right now. Go on now.
Listen here, son. I'd get this bus out of here, and if I was you, I'd do it pretty quick.
Well, we'd be happy to, Sheriff. It's just as soon as we can get some gas.
You got all the gas you're getting.
Roy, go put that thing up. Pete, give him enough gas to get out of here.
Y'all boys hear me?
Appreciate it, Sheriff.
Tell no story, Mama. Am I, Rachel?
There was a whole bus of civil rights workers. Y'all should have seen everybody standing around staring.
One of them was named Glenn. And he come over to Rachel, and he... Oh, Rachel!
Who, Rachel what?
Daddy!
He was talking to Rachel, and she was talking back to him.
Now, hush up, Paulette. Was the sheriff there?
He sure was. He was so mad, he was about to turn three shades of red.
He made him leave. Get out of town and don't come back, he said.
I'm glad he ran him off.
Why, Daddy? Aren't they gonna try to help Negroes to get some rights?
That's what they calls themselves doing. But it seems like more Negroes is getting hurt than help. We don't need no Mega Evers type of killing in Catesville.
But don't you and Mama want to vote?
Yeah, we want to vote. I cried when I couldn't vote for John Kennedy. I cried.
Until the president gets us our voting rights, we can't be no engine and we can't be no caboose. So we might as well leave things alone.
What has happened to you?
Mama, I got a family to protect.
Aren't there some good white folks in Catesville that help the civil rights workers?
Girl, don't be no fool. Pass me the chicken salad.
What do you think? One lump or two?
I ain't gonna be going no place. This is sure to be a sweet bus.
Hey, what's going on out there?
Hey, get away from that bus!
Terrific. Welcome to Catesville.
Yeah. Well, if that's all that happened, just consider yourself lucky. Look, boy, why don't y'all just take the hint and move on from where you're not wanted? The Justice Department? Well, call them all you want. No. Look here, son, I... Hello?
Who's that, honey?
Oh, nobody. Some voter registration people get what they deserve.
Daddy, do you think that colored people ought to have the right to vote?
Jenny, voting can be a very serious thing, especially if you're not used to it. Any Tom, Dick, Harry, or Martin Luther King could come along and promise them the moon. And the coloreds might vote without even thinking.
Mama's right, honey. You see, you just can't trust them with some things like voting.
None of them?
None of them. It's not their fault, and it's not anything against them, really.
What about Annie and Rachel and them?
Well, that's different. They're not like the others.
And how come they're not?
Because they're not. There's exceptions to every rule.
No.
Annie has been a part of this family ever since I can remember. She practically raised me. Shoot, her last name's practically Conley.
Well, then are you saying that Annie should have the right to vote?
No, I am not saying that.
Roy?
Sheriff?
Hey, Pete.
Now, listen, I'm going to say this just once, so I want y'all boys to listen up. You keep away from that bus, you hear me?
Sheriff, now, we didn't do
it. Oh, shut up, Roy. You got the only white rag cop in the county. About half the townspeople saw y'all hightailing it out of there. Now, what's the matter with you two? Don't you know that the feds are just itching to come over here and mess around in our business? They're all over Philadelphia, Mississippi, ever since them three boys disappeared over there.
Come on, Sheriff. You know these kids bring these problems on themselves.
That is not the issue, Pete. We just don't want outsiders coming around here in Catesville. Now, don't you understand that? Huh?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, y'all let me handle this, okay? You hear me?
And good day to you, sir.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Put those up here, kid.
This be all for you today, William?
Yes, sir. That about do it.
Okay. Y'all playing ball tomorrow?
The others probably will. I will lift with the pain. Where's Floyd?
I am Floyd.
Doggone, one of y'all ought to grow a mustache or something.
Sheriff Connolly tells me that you were in Korea.
Marines. I was up in Panmunjom.
I was in the Army. 39th parallel. All this time, and I never knew you were a vet.
Oh, well, me, you. You know, some of my buddies, they stayed in the service. They say it's getting kind of hot over there in Vietnam.
Well, we got to make a stand somewhere. I mean, you got to hold the line against communism.
Right. Right. Sometimes I wish I had stayed in the service. Kind of like strapping on my gear and testing myself against whatever was out there. Pays a lot more than house painting.
Well, if you ever get tired of spreading paint and think you might like selling it, come and talk to me. I just lost a good man. I could use the help.
You serious?
Like Sears and Roebuck. Look, keep your painting on the side and work for me during the week.
Thank you, Mr. Reese. You know, I got a few jobs to finish up, but I'll be in the talk with you right after that.
You do that now. Us vets got to stick together.
Yes, sir.
William, that'll be $13.62 for the paint and extension pole.
If the world was mine to give, it would be yours and we could live a life of love and peace. Enjoy. You be my girl, and I'll be your boy. Like the light from the sun above, I shine on you with all my love. Yours truly, your secret admirer. At first, I thought, maybe. Wanna know who I really thought it came from at first? Jenny, you're not even listening.
What? Oh, yeah, I am.
I said, do you want to know who I thought it came from at first?
Who?
Him. The one on the bus. Glenn.
Oh, you don't think it could be, do you?
Nah, besides, he don't even know where I live. So it had to be Kevin.
Kevin?
Who else but some old railhead like that would be so dumb as to send me this junk?
Right.
How's everybody feeling this afternoon, huh? Well, Rachel, aren't you gonna speak to me, or has the cat got your tongue?
Hmm? Hello. Oh, wee, Rachel, I'm gonna tell.
Shut your mouth up, Paulette.
Paulette, huh? Well, I think Paulette's a pretty name. How are you? And who's this?
His name's Kevin.
Kevin, huh? How you doing, Kevin?
You really a freedom rider?
Well, I suppose you might say that, yeah. Now, we can count on you to help us spread the word about the rally, can't we? Rachel?
Oh, Glenn.
Reverend.
Glenn, I want you to meet Brother Williams. Brother Williams is one of my most staunchest members and father of these two lovely young ladies over here.
Well, sir, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Come on, kids. We got a lot of work to do today. Good day, Reverend.
Well, listen, I sure hope we can count on you to help us organize the voters' registration drive here in Catesville.
Catesville doesn't need a voters' registration drive.
Well, think about it.
I have.
Well, I hope you change your mind.
I hope you change yours and move on. Good day.
About 100 Negroes picketed in front of the LaFleur County Courthouse protesting against alleged discrimination in voting and promoting voter registration. Only 3% of the county's Negro majority are registered to vote. According to student organizers, at least 1,500 Negroes have tried to register in the last 3 weeks. County officials claim the Negroes have been denied registration for legitimate reasons. The pickets ignored police warnings and were arrested. Two girls struggled vigorously with police before they were dragged off. Altogether, 100 Negroes were arrested. No injuries were reported. Student leaders vowed to be back tomorrow and every day thereafter until they achieved their goal. In other news, yesterday in Indianola, Mississippi, civil rights workers announced they would intensify their drive to register Negro voters. For the last several days, long lines of prospective voters have stood for hours, only to be turned away without being allowed to register. According to spokesmen for the project, registration activists plan to have workers in every part of the county within the next several days.
That's him. That's the one from the bus. He was at church today.
Hey, don't you worry about it. Another thing, y'all better stay away from around him or any other civil rights workers if they come around here. You hear me?
Yes, Dad.
And are on the road to Mississippi for the summer. Go take your baths.
They were taught how to react when confronted by hostile segregationists, how to protect their heads, how to fall, how to ward off blows.
They coming back to Catesville?
The students were subjected to all forms of physical and mental abuse in the training program led by veteran civil rights workers at the Ohio House.
Lightning's gonna strike the outhouse.
In spite of the news of their missing friends, Schwerner, Cheney, and Goodman, none of the students have dropped out of the program.
Because when I do find out who the secret Meyer is who sent you that poem, I'm gonna break every bone in his body.
A poem from a secret admirer, huh?
Yeah, and it was real mushy, too. mushy. Right there in black and white.
Black and white, huh? Oh, I bet it was. Right there in black and white. Come back here.
Hey, Jenny, which one of the twins do you like?
Neither one of them.
Come on, y'all, wait up!
Nah, you said you did.
I just made that up.
No, you didn't. You meant it.
No, I didn't. You're so stupid. You don't even know when somebody's playing.
But you can't like Rachel. She's colored. She's colored, Lloyd, colored. Good and colored.
Why can't you just mind your own business? This don't concern you.
It does too concern me. It concerns our whole family. Any fool can see. That's him.
Daddy! Daddy!
We saw that guy from the bus. He's back again. The guy from the bus is back. Glenn. They're gonna start a demonstration.
Now, wait a minute. Nobody said anything about a demonstration. The sheriff told him to get out of town, and he's back. We saw him with Reverend Wilson.
Right. Is Sheriff Connolly there?
No.
Darn. Stanley, you excuse me if I be right back?
No, I'll take your time. That boy's real well trained there.
Yeah, they're good kids, and I'm real proud of them. It's a quiet town, and we have to keep it quiet. There's going to be real trouble around here if we don't put an end to this thing right now. Come on, boys. Come on! Let's go!
One last point, and I want to reemphasize this. Make sure you get the pamphlets to the heads.
I thought I told you to get out of Catesville. Now, come on, let's go.
Wait a minute, Sheriff.
No, you wait a minute, Reverend Wilson. I got a job to do here.
Sheriff Connolly, I realize that you might find it difficult to respect us as human beings, but the least you can do is respect our place of worship, and please refrain from shouting.
All right. Now, look, son, we don't have any racial problem here in Catesville,
And I'm not going to have you coming in here and stirring up trouble.
Sheriff Conley, that man is an American citizen.
Reverend Wilson, that's all right, and I appreciate your hospitality, but I'm going to cut this visit short, okay?
That's right. You might be an American citizen. You might be his invited guest, but you're disturbing the peace. So don't let the sun set on you here, because you'll be my guest down at the jailhouse first thing in the morning. Let's go.
I'll be back, Sheriff.
Oh, no, I don't think I'd come back if I was you.
Reverend Wilson, I'll be back. Y'all hear me? I will be back. And I won't be alone, Sheriff.
What's wrong, Janet? You still worried about making that cheerleading squad at your school?
Oh, that's not it.
Well, what is it then?
Miss Annie, what do you do when you like somebody, like someone else?
Oh, is that what it is? Well, that's just a part of growing up, baby. Besides, any boy who don't like you back must be pretty dumb. No point in pining away over a dummy.
That's all right. Hi.
Hello.
Ooh, ow!
Gosh darn it, Annie, you like to broke my hand.
Like you like to broke my rule. You know not to peek into my pot. No cornbread, monkey bread, with your dinner.
Oh, I'll take either one.
You better pick one.
Annie, what do you think about this civil rights mess?
Well, number one, I don't think it's mess.
Well, I think it's mess, and I think it's a whole lot worse.
I thought you asked me what I thought. It's not mess. Mess ain't necessary. Civil rights is.
Why?
So my babies won't have to grow old tending other people's pots and pans and washing their dirty drawers.
Yeah, I can't believe I'm hearing this. This kitchen's looked after your family ever since I can remember.
Pets, plants, and property need looking after. People ought to be able to look after themselves.
All these years? Why ain't you never said nothing like that before?
You never asked me before. Now, do you want cornbread or monkey bread with your dinner?
Okay, but you hurry back now, because it's almost dinner time.
Yes, ma'am. I want to go, too.
Rachel, take Paulette with you.
No!
What's wrong with you, girl?
Well, I get tired always having to take her with me.
Well, I get tired of always having to iron your clothes. I got enough on my mind. Now, if you want to go to the park, you take her with you.
Oh, shoot.
I got a letter, and it's sealed with a kiss. Who sent it to you? That's what I'm gonna find out. And you can't read it because it's private. What are we doing here? I'm meeting somebody, okay?
Rachel, hi.
Hey, Floyd.
I'm Lloyd.
Y'all need to get t-shirts with y'all's name on them or something.
What's wrong?
Nothing. Have you been here long?
Since about 4 o'clock.
Did you see anybody over here? Any boys or anybody?
No.
Guess he's not coming then.
Who?
Just somebody I was supposed to meet here.
Rachel.
Huh? What, Lloyd? What are you looking so goofy for? What do you want?
Look, I just want you. Never mind.
Lloyd.
gotta go to the bathroom.
We'll be home soon.
I can't wait!
You have to wait. They still haven't fixed the colored bathroom.
I can't use a white bathroom. I used it last time. No!
Girl, I'm gonna tan you good. Why did you let her do that?
I didn't let her do it. She just did it.
Don't matter who let her do it or who didn't let her do it. The point is, she better not do it again. Now, she broke the law. And if you can't control your children, me and the state of Mississippi will. And I want that understood clearly and completely.
Yes, sir.
Do you know I got... William. I have the right to send them to the reform school in Pikesville tomorrow. I don't want no bad feelings between us. They're Annie's kids. But I can't just let Rachel and Paulette go around doing things they ain't got no business doing.
They won't do it no more. I promise you that.
Well, I'm going to count on you for that, William. And I'm going to count on you to talk to your friends and your neighbors just in case that civil rights bunch tries to start up here.
I'll talk to them the best I can, Mr. Conley.
Good. All right. Because you know that all heck could break loose, and I'd hate to see y'all caught up in the middle of that.
Won't. It sure won't.
You know, I really need your help on this, William.
Get inside that house, Rachel. You too, Paulette. Dad, both of you, get inside that house right now.
Go on, both of you, go on.
I'll beat some sense into both of you.
William, you shouldn't whip them.
They know better.
Yeah, you're right. And I told them. I'm scared, too, of what might happen, but not enough to beat my babies.
Stay out of this, son.
William!
Make you feel more like a man to beat your babies because one of them used a white bathroom?
Don't you think it's better for me to whip them now than for them to be in trouble with the law later?
Well, those little welts and bruises you gave them will be gone soon. But the scars on their souls be there forever.
Job at the hardware store would have put us ahead for once, baby.
William, we'll get by.
I guess I'm scared. Something's coming. Changing.
That's right, it's changing. We got to deal with it. We're gonna have to take a stand sooner or later.
Paulette, come here, baby. Come here. Come here.
Under arrest. Now come on, let's go.
Whoa,
the charge is anything I say it is. Who are you?
Ralph Estridge from the NAACP.
Well, let me tell you something, son. You just watch your step, or you're going to go to jail like your friend
look,
here.
Look, Sheriff, I'm just trying to find out what the charge is, so I can
just
bail him.
You don't have to know.
Excuse me. Has the meeting started yet?
No. No, as a matter of fact, y'all are right on time.
Please, come right this way.
Hi, Rachel.
Hello. Well, how you feel this morning?
Annie, you know what this means, don't you?
Yes, I do. But I was tired of making your monkey bread anyway.
Let me try it.
Still got a practice.
Can't do it.
Yeah, I bet you I can.
Hang on, let me wind it.
You can't do it. Says who?
Guys, take skill, you know?
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So tense moment, ladies and gentlemen, as he tries to bring it up. He got it!
A ducking yo-yo. Where'd you get it?
What's wrong with y'all? Look, my daddy don't want me and Lloyd messing with you anymore. And this is our park, so you'd better get.
What do you mean I better get?
I mean, this is our park, nigger. So don't let us catch any of you around here again. Ever. You got it?
What's the problem, man? I even did. Hey, don't do it again.
Stop it, you all! You're not even fighting over nothing. Come on.
Stay out of it.
Let me go! Quit it! All right, enough.
What you doing to him? Get off! Get off, Floyd! Get off!
To your child. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
miss you too, Jimmy.
When are you coming home? To our house?
I'm already at home, Jenny. I wonder about you sometimes. How's Miss Lily and the sheriff doing?
They're fine. They do miss you too.
I know that's right. Do they know you came over here?
No, ma'am. I didn't even know I was coming at first. Started walking and asking for you until I found you.
That's better. That's better.
Why don't you children go outside and play? Go on, all of you, so I can finish reading my paper. Scat!
Listen. You think we could still be friends? You know, no hard feelings.
I don't know. I mean, I wouldn't mind, but my dad.
What?
He says that we can't play together anymore.
My dad said the same thing. I don't like Lloyd anymore. Does everything Lloyd tells him.
Yeah. They're not my friends anymore either.
Now, don't you think they're the dumbest people you've ever met before?
Pull it!
That's right. I agree.
Get her, girl.
Let's pull up high.
Swing it.
Wait a second. Okay, pull up.
I get in there next.
Okay.